Hi guys, we are CFX Squad.
And today we're unboxing the Zama gaming headset.
So,
this is it. Yep, Zama, the one and only in the flesh, or should I say in the box. First impressions, the box always looks good with Trust Gaming. I like the designs, but I want to see the headset itself. What's your first impression?
It's kind of big, but I like big, so.
Yellow. Quality-wise,
this is nice.
Looks good. How does it feel?
It feels good, it's light. Yeah, check it out.
It is actually kind of light. So what I like about this headset is that it's multi-platform. I don't know about you, but I have a PS4 at home, but I also game on PC, and I like that I just can use one headset for all my gaming needs. But it feels good, it's light, that's what I like about this, so it's easy. It doesn't feel like you have something with a lot of weight on your neck or on your head. Let me see if I have it the right way, yeah. This is also very handy. It has the R and L.
I need that. Guys.
So I like the premium feel, but I also see that it's a detachable microphone.
Yeah, I think it's very important because if you want to use this just on the streets, if you want to listen to music or something, you don't want to have this thing sticking out in front of you.
Because no, that would be a little bit weird.
You're broadcasting a live F1 race or something all the time.
Yeah.
And I like the pop filter. I think that's a very important thing.
Yes. And I think one of the things that I don't enjoy when I'm on voice platforms like Discord or Skype is people that keep breathing in their mic. And one of the things that makes that go away way more is a pop filter. So yep. I like that.
Yeah.
It looks really good on you, actually. Yeah. It's not too big. It looks like you're gonna present a Rainbow Six Siege commentary.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
The Trust Gaming Rainbow Six Siege esports match.
Team. Mont. So there is something special about this headset in here.
Yeah.
Normally a headset has 50 millimeter active speaker units.
Yep.
But what's special about this one?
53.
It has 53, so it's way more powerful.
Mm-hmm.
So next to a multi-platform gaming headset, this is also the ideal headset for on the go.
Because in the box is a 1 meter cable that also has a microphone.
Ooh, it's nice, it's braided.
Yeah, you know this microphone from phones with an iPhone or another phone. You can plug this one in and use it on the go.
But wait, phone calls. You don't just plug it in because you can take off your headset mic. And if you can see at the bottom is another 3.5 millimeter jack input. So you put it in there?
Not in this one, in this one. It's very important. Plug it in and put it on.
Mom? Hey, Mom. Another thing I really like about a Zamak is its premium finish. There are metal parts that makes it feel really sturdy and that it can take a punch.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, the first impressions are it's a really cool, good-looking headset for gaming, multi-platform and on the run. But there's only one way to find out if this headset really is any good.
How does it sound?
I have to say, the fit is really, really, really good. One of the things in Siege that is, I think one of the most important things in Siege is sound. And by sound, I mean directional sound. You really have to know where the sound is coming from to kill people. First impressions are it's really good. It's really noise canceling. So I'm sorry if I'm really shouting at you guys right now because I have no idea. Am I shouting?
You're shouting. Nice.
This directional sound is really good. I immediately knew where they were. First impressions, it's really good. I like the fact that it's an over-ear. Like I said, I really love over-ear because it's more comfortable for longer gaming sessions. And it's also more noise canceling for the things around you. And I had the feeling that I was in T-Hunt now. Mm-hmm. And not that you were here and a camera guy was looking at me. So that's a real plus for me.
That's good. Did you try the vertical sound?
Yeah, but I love the vertical sound. It's not simulating surround like it's not there.
Mm-hmm.
It's just raw sound input. It gives you a real good idea of where the sound is coming from, where the source is. So this would be a headset I would use.
Cool.
So I think I'm taking this one with me
after
shooting. But I think you should give it a try.
Okay.
You are also a very avid gamer.
That's right.
Let's go.
I really like the shells. I really like that.
Another thing that I really liked, I don't know if you are going to feel the same way about it, it's not too tight on your head.
Yeah, true.
It's the fit is good.
I did use other headsets that are very tight, and like 5 minutes later, it's like cramped and sweaty, and
I feel you. Yeah.
All right, sounds good.
Sounds good, huh?
I'm gonna try a grenade.
You don't have grenades.
Okay, well, thank you. Okay, shoot. All right, it's good. All right, I can hear the opponent over there, so I like that.
So let's see if he's actually, yeah, he is over there, so.
You know, that's so important in games, their audio, you know, it's like, if you mess that up.
So when you are a competitive gamer, so you really like being, in the first place, a leaderboard, you need a headset like this.
Yeah.
You need a good headset that has good directional sound and has honest and fair sound. So there are a lot of headsets from companies that try virtual sound.
Oh, wow. That sounds good.
Yeah?
Yeah. I was like really confused because I heard vertical sound. Oh, that's very good. I hear someone shouting like over there. Yeah, that's good. I really like that. Flash. Dying sounds good.
So, dying?
Yeah. That sounds
what?
Good.
What?
I like it. I died, but no.
Dying sounds good.
It's immersive. You're in your game. It's your world over there. And I love that. And that's very important to me. So would recommend this headset.
Look back on what we just found out about the headset.
Uh-huh.
It's a great headset for travel because of the inline mic that you get with the product.
Yeah.
The fit is very good. It's a premium headset, so there's metal parts in it. It's multi-platform, so if I want a game on my PS4 and then play some Siege on my PC, I can just take it with me. I think the end verdict, the sound is good. It's great, actually. I'm really, really surprised. Would you buy it?
Yeah, I think I would buy it. Yeah. And I think this will be the first headset, my first gaming headset, that I will take with me on a plane. I normally don't do noise canceling and stuff, I just have earbuds, but I think this is the first one I was like, okay, I'm going to travel, plane, noise, I will put this one on and kind of quiet, so great.
So, is it CFX Squad approved?
CFX Squad approved.
Nice.